Now with us on the guest line, a man who's already busy week, may have gotten a touch more hectic, nutritionist to the stars, power athlete nutrition coach, Tyler Minton is with us. Tyler, crazy 24 hours, man. It's good to see you appear to be holding up all right. What's going on, man?
Yeah, man, it's been pretty unreal. It's already going to be an extremely hectic week. You know, I work with George Lockhart, and we had seven people on this card as it was, you know, so we had a full week ahead of us. And then, you know, you get the call that not only is your main event's opponent out, but your main event is being replaced with someone else who you guys work with and someone who was not prepared to come in and be ready, but we got to get him ready. So it's this sports savage. I love it.
Oh,
it's unpredictable, man. What a it's this is a journalist's dream. Nutritionist's I don't want to say nightmare. It's a dream for us too. Me and George were discussing it last night. It's really kind of awesome, but it's been nuts.
Well, he couldn't have a better team trying to attack this weight cut and everything that goes with the challenges over the next 5 or 6 days. You are a pro fighter yourself with a 6-1 record. So how best, if you're Max Holloway, and we'll get to Khabib Nurmagomedov, but how best to attack the 5 days that he has here on the clock, which, of course, is ticking as we speak?
Yeah, so when he called, you know, he spoke with me and George. We both immediately started making some arrangements for him to – you know, to make the weight, whether or not the fight happened or not. I mean, the second we even heard about it, there were things that needed to happen. We, you know, we had him change his water up. We had him change his diet up a little bit just to immediately start, you know, kind of getting that water down, flushing out some inflammation. So we immediately started attacking that. And then we literally crunched numbers. I had all the numbers from Max's last weight cut. We track everything. I mean, we're food dudes, but we approach this with science, and that's why we've stood the test of time with all these athletes. We don't just, you know, there's no bro science here. There's a lot of numbers, facts, and figures. We got together, we put those together, we compared it to Max's last two weight cuts, with where he's got to be on this weight cut, and we found that it is a possible feat. And once we were determined that it was possible, we said, yeah, we'll do it. We can make it happen. And you know, Max caught a flight.
So Tyler, was that a part of the decision process on Max's part? Was checking with you first to see if that weight cut was possible?
Absolutely. I mean, Max is a dream client. I mean, he really is. And we'll get to Khabib. He is as well. So I want to give fair, you know, unbiased
right.
opinion on both. But Max will do anything, man. This kid. The first thing he did was reach out to us, and he wanted to make sure it was even possible. He wanted to make sure it was something that he could do healthy, and he didn't trust, you know, anyone else. Like he talked to us, and his manager talked to us, and Brian Butler, and they just wanted to make 100% sure it was something that we could have in control before he even accepted it.
Tyler, can you give us any insight as to like what his mentality was, or kind of what he was talking about when he was telling you about this crazy news?
I'll tell you one thing about Max Holloway, and I don't, you know, I've been with him his last two camps. You know, unfortunately the last one had a little bit of an issue with the ankle, and we didn't get to finish it. But one thing I learned, man, Hawaiians are a different breed of human. They are relentless. It blows my mind how, you know, just they're warriors, man. And all that really was going through his head, and I think he would be comfortable with me saying this, so I'll say it. Max Holloway thinks Khabib Nurmagomedov is the best fighter in the world, and that is enough for Max Holloway to want to fight Khabib Nurmagomedov.
Wow. Now, have you been around Khabib's camp as well? Have you seen him train? Have you seen him work out?
Yeah. Yeah, so his last camp, I was there for weeks because I had him in D.C. at the same time. I had Khabib in D.C. for the first 3 weeks, then D.C. for the last 3 weeks alone. And I always train with the guys. I love to train. You know, it's a blast for me. And I get to know a little bit about them. You know, it's one thing to imagine what their energy levels are, but it's another thing if you feel the difference in their energy levels. And, you know, as a fighter, and that's, you know, that's where me and George have an advantage, I think, over, you know, people who in the past, we're competitors or whatever in this sport. We felt it, you know, we know what this feels like. We know what the fighters need. So, yeah, I always want to roll with them. And, You know, another story I feel comfortable saying, Daniel Cormier had told me, he's like, Khabib Nurmagomedov is the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world. And when Daniel Cormier, who is, I mean, arguably the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world, right, is saying this, you're curious. So I went and I wanted to roll with Khabib so bad. You know, I was a wrestler, I was a fighter, and I was, you know, grappling was my thing. And it was probably the most embarrassing 5 minutes of my entire life.
That, you believe it,
man.
I used to think the bear thing was like, yeah, that's a little fat. Nah, man, I'm a bear hunter. Like, I hunt bears in Tennessee. Yeah. I'm a redneck. And I would firmly take Khabib Nurmagomedov with me bear hunting and think he could take one down. It's absolutely ridiculous. It is ridiculous what this kid is like when he gets his hands on someone.
How would you compare them as fighters? You've been around them, been around their training camps. What are there some differences and some similarities in their games and their approaches?
Yeah, you know, the biggest thing is it's the dream MMA mashup. You have the guy who's, you know, a little leans towards striking, but is also a grappler. You know, Max obviously trains grappling. He knows how to grapple. You know, you don't become a champion in this sport if you suck at anything, really. You know, but Max is very much a more skilled striker than he is a grappler, or at least he uses his striking. That's what he's known as. The guy picks guys apart and laughs and, you know, claps while he's doing it. Khabib is one of the best wrestlers in the world, you know. So, you know, not that Khabib doesn't know how to strike. You know, he displayed some really good striking in his last fight and really outstruck Barbosa. You know, his strikes were landing, man. It was beautiful. But Khabib is obviously more geared towards grappling. So you have, you know, the true mixed martial artist dream here in a better grappler versus a better striker, and let's see who's average beats the other. Mm-hmm. You know, they're both just absolutely tenacious. Their work ethic's insane. Neither of them fight with hate or animosity. They love to fight. So it's really cool. It's weird, you know. It kind of it's tough to be with both men because I care about them both so much. They're, you know, I'd consider them both extremely close friends. They're great people, two of the best people I've met, not even in the sport, just in life in general. So it's, you know, it's really a dream matchup, in my opinion, for everyone who's watching.
Tyler Minton with us here on the Anik and Florian podcast. Tremendous insight you're providing into both sides of this equation. I'd imagine, though, you had to think at some point, and maybe it's already happened in the UFC, given how many athletes you guys are working with, that it was only a matter of time before you were going head-to-head in a high-profile situation like we've got this weekend.
Yeah, I mean, and we've done it before. You know, we've had, like, James Vick and Joe Duffy fought each other.
Right.
You know, and it was weird. I was with both guys, and they both said kind of the same thing. They're like, well, you know, I want to fight the best Joe Duffy, or I want to fight the best James Vick. And if you can get them in there as their absolute best, then that's what we want. These guys are the exact same. You know, that's kind of what makes our company. We have a team. You know, we got several individuals here. We're growing our team. You know, a lot of new guys who are training with us this week, and it's the perfect week for them to do so. You know, and they came in on a good week, but it's that's one thing that makes us what we do. You know, we're professional. We'll work with anyone because we're here to do a job, and that job's not only to help them make weight, but to help them to perform at the best, you know, at their highest possible level. And our relationship with the fighters has nothing to do with that. Our job is to get them in there, and we can do that. And once we do that, the best man will win. You know, my job's to get Khabib on weight and help him perform at his best. Khabib's job's to get in there and fight. You know, our job's the same thing with Max Holloway, and we'll give them both equal treatment. We'll give them both a job and, you know, our best job, and we'll let them handle what they're supposed to handle.
I'm sensing a monthly segment, the Melee Minute for Get Ray Longo, man, here on the Anik and Florian podcast. Tyler, I appreciate your time. I'll leave you with this. Khabib Nurmagomedov, at least to the untrained eye, seemed to master everything about this weight management process prior to the Edson Barboza fight. I don't know how far you guys go back, but is that fair to say that ahead of that Barboza fight, Khabib did everything right, and it is your expectation that that's exactly what we'll see here again during this fight week?
Yeah, you know, I worked with him for that fight. You know, that was my first time working with him, and, man, he showed up. You know, I got a lot of notoriety from it because people saw me on the scale, or, you know, at the scale with Khabib, and you know, people saw me with him all week, but the fact is, man, if you give us an unprepared, unprofessional you know, athlete, client who's just not doing their job, we can't do our job. Khabib Nurmagomedov came to me already prepared. He came to us with a whole new attitude. He was doing everything he could. He was doing everything right when we met up. So it made my job extremely easy. He approached the way he should. So, you know, we're here to make it the absolute best. But, yeah, you're 100% right. Khabib Nurmagomedov, you know, did the work. He did everything he could. And you know, this camp's the same way. He showed up. He showed up with no doubt in my mind it's going to be an insanely easy weight cut. You know, so we got a good, we'll have a good outcome.
Octagon News.